Hi guys, welcome to MotionCam channel. This time my face will be hidden and I will show more the application instead. So once you start up the app, it should look like this in a landscape mode. I will try to introduce you to most of the future of the app now. It's important to note that the main file of the app is called mcraw container, is used for capturing lossless, compressed raw video frames. In this table, you can see how different type of content can change the compression ratio. Now that we understood the value of mcraw container, we need to know where to set up this file first. Press on the option button and to choose where to save the mcraw container. I'm going to do this now. From here, as you can see, we can set where to store a mcraw container. In my case, I'm going to use this folder where I already have some files saved. So my next recordings will be in this location. Other settings that you can check, you can find them in arrow menu. Here we have the UI controls that we can set. We can maximize viewfinder. We can set up all these settings. So here we have optical image stabilization option. We have the default viewer. Also, we have motion cam viewer. You can check both of them as well. Torch. From here, you can enable or disable cameras that work or not work for your phone. In my case, number 2 is not working, so I'm gonna disable it. As well, from here, you can choose the raw resolution supported by the phone. In this case, I set up maximum resolution in RAW 10 container. We have the photo mode. From here, you can choose to save both JPEG and DNG. Next category is important. Here we can set up the capture frame rate. In the first row, we have the official supported frame rates. As well, it's recommended for you to try also the unsupported frame rates. On some phones, might work. In order to improve the RAW capture performance, you can increase the crop value till you find a stable capture. Also, you can try pixel binding capture. As well, we have already defined settings. So in my case, I'm gonna use like this. Having this this format 16:9, I can use more the screen by going to UI, and from here we can enable maximize viewfinder. So now I'm using all the screen. For example, if I would go and choose another radio, a wider one, would take advantage too. 4:3, 16:9. Let's see what other functions we have. As well, you can make a time lapse. We have an about page where you can rate us if you like. As well, we have a Discord community. With these tools, you can convert mcraw container into DNGs, or you can convert directly into ProRes with Cineform log. We have experimental features that we add here in beta versions, saving Jira data that can be used later on with this amazing software called the Jira Flow. And with this software, you can stabilize the footage. We have manual controls. You can set up the ISO and the shutter. So let's enable the histogram, focus peaking, and sensor clipping. As you can see, we can change the focus. I want to overexpose a little bit just to show you how sensor clipping looks like. Another important feature is the ability to lock the focus once you are happy with the value. For example, if I touch now by mistake, it's gonna refocus. But if I focus and I manual lock, then focus will stay there fixed, no matter what. So let's take one test. I'm gonna set up the exposure that I would prefer to have. I'm happy like this. To preview and render the container, we need to go to manage videos. From here, you can render each clip separate. First, you can render the clip into DNGs locally. Second, you can render to a video format. And third, you can render one photo from the video. We can preview and render the video at the same time. What we recorded. Also, we can set up the transfer function. Let's say I'm going to use log, and I'm going to decide to save as H.264, and I will use maximum bitrate. That's it. But as well, if I want, I can set up Cineon log with ProRes. This will save me in 10 bits. Original size. In this moment, the app is rendering the clip. Same container, we can render one image if you want. From here, we can save an individual image as DNG or JPEG. Thank you for watching. In next tutorial, I will showcase how to convert mcraw container with MotionCam tools that are available for Windows and macOS.